Intopia. WCAG 2.2 at a glance. 3.3.8 Accessible Authentication Minimum. As more of our world moves online, keeping our accounts and information safe is a top priority. Authentication asks people to prove their identity in multiple ways to reduce the risk. This could be entering information they know, entering information they receive, or doing something to prove they are who they say they are. Success Criterion 3.3.8 Accessible Authentication Minimum is about making sure login methods are accessible and easy to use, as well as secure. An accessible login method doesn't require people to remember, transcribe, or solve information without help. These are considered cognitive function tests, and they can make logging in very difficult for some people. Let's break each of these down a bit further. Some people have trouble remembering information. Asking a person to enter personal information, such as a name, email, or phone number, is okay. This information is common to the person and doesn't change no matter what they're doing. But usernames and passwords differ from site to site and can be difficult to remember. When a username, password, or any other non-personal information is required, we can meet this criterion by enabling mechanisms that assist with recall. For example, this might be enabling a person to copy and paste their password in or enter their password using a password manager. Some people have trouble transcribing information. Transcription is a common feature of two-factor authentication. Like when a user is given a code that they must manually input into a verification text field. When this method is used, we can satisfy this criterion by enabling ways that don't require transcription, such as a person copying and pasting the verification code. For this criterion, copying and pasting is acceptable, even if it's across devices. But don't forget to consider how easy or difficult that might be for someone. Word-based captures. Where a person must identify and transcribe a word, and there is no accessible alternative, cannot meet this criterion. Some people have trouble solving puzzles. Puzzles are often used in capture-based authentication, which may need a person to solve a math equation, drag a shape into place, or match two items. Puzzles can create problems for many kinds of people. Because of this, most puzzles are not permitted under this criterion. There are two kinds of puzzle that are acceptable. The first is object recognition, such as selecting all cars in a set of images. The second is personal content recognition, where a person can upload their own non-text content, like a photo, and then identify it from a set of options. Keep in mind, this type of capture isn't going to work for people with no or limited vision. So an alternative that meets this criterion will still be necessary. There is a level AAA version of this criterion, 3.3.9 Accessible Authentication Enhanced. The difference between minimum and enhanced is that recognizing objects and personal content are not permitted in the level AAA version. Now that we've broken down our main requirements, we can also consider providing an alternative login method that is not a cognitive function test. Some examples include hardware authentication devices, such as a YubiKey, authenticating with your device, such as a fingerprint or facial scan, allowing personal information like an email as an alternative to a username, or responding to a security notification on a second device. Accessible authentication is a complex criterion with many ways to meet it, so it's worth exploring further. Because we don't want to steal our users' independence in exchange for security.